This is not the first video that I'm making on the subject. If you're new here, well, welcome. You're gonna learn how to make a Twitch panel. And if you're not new here, today I actually wanna show you how you can get inspiration from video games that you're playing or want to play or that you just like the graphic aesthetic of in order to create your own branding. You're gonna pick a color scheme and then a graphic style based on that specific video game. We're basically gonna observe, we're gonna take inspiration, and then we're gonna apply that to the graphics that we're gonna be making. Is this too complicated? Well, don't worry about it. If you don't wanna learn how to make some meticulous graphic design and all that, today's sponsor is actually OWN, and they can take care of that for you. First thing you want to do is go to own.gg/getlevel, and they're constantly having huge sales. Right now, there's 50% sales with this code. Also, there are some official Call of Duty stream designs that you can get right from here. And it's not just once, there's a bunch of them. All of those are Call of Duty inspired or Call of Duty related. You can hover over them to have a quick look, but let's just click and check it out. So you're gonna get some animated overlays starting soon, stream ending, stream be right back and all that stuff, intermission screen. You're gonna get camera overlays. You're gonna get some panels, of course. You're gonna get animated alerts that go with them, and you can modify all of those. Here's the panels, the offline image, you get a banner, you even get a profile picture. And of course, that's not all. There's a bunch of other game-related overlay packs. If you want to create your own emotes, your sub badges, all of that is included in own.gg/getlevel. Go check it out. That is own3d.gg/getlevel. So the huge point that I want to drive in this video is that you can take inspiration from the games that you like in order to create some graphics that are pretty similar. The whole point of having branding as a content creator is that it makes you more memorable if you have a specific graphic style and a specific color scheme. And I get a lot of questions like, how did you do this? How do you make this panel? How do you do that? The fact is, you simply have to observe and also know the basics of any editing software, or in this case, website. We're gonna be using a website, no download, no nothing. And it's basically Photoshop for free. It's called photopia.com. Let's say that we enjoy Valorant. I would take a screenshot of just a poster. I could, you know, go into the game and screenshot the UI and try to get inspiration that. But straight from the poster, we can figure out what the color scheme is. It is that dark blue as the background image, and then we have that bright red as the highlight image, and then the details are basically those diagonal lines, the fact that the red glows a little bit so it will blend in with the dark blue, and then the kind of specific font. Now, you don't need to play Valorant to have a Valorant-inspired branding. The idea here is to get inspired by the style. For example, let's say that you are a content creator that's only based on horror games, right? You only play horror games. It wouldn't make sense for you to have a Animal Crossing theme or a Fall Guys theme or even a Fortnite looking theme, right? You would want dark graphics, maybe some fire, maybe some grungy text and stuff like that, and vice versa. Anyways, hopefully that makes sense. I'm gonna show you what I created like earlier, because of course I did this so many times, but basically this is the first design that I created that was Valorant inspired, and we're gonna be making something like it. So go to photopia.com, click on new project, and this is where we're gonna put basically the size of the project. Twitch panels are usually 320 when it comes to the width. It's gonna be resized no matter what, how big it is basically. So I like to put 640 because it's double the size, it's gonna look HD basically. And then the height, I'm also gonna put 640, and I'll decide on the actual height a little bit later. DPI, we want to keep that at 300, and click create. All right, now just take a screenshot of whatever you want to get inspired by, and then go back to Photopia, click Control V, press Control V to paste basically, and there it is. Now, this is the part where we observe. What are we observing? The color scheme, first of all, what is it? We have background's gonna be dark blue, and then highlight is gonna be this red. There are some white lines, but we'll add that later. So basically, this is the color scheme. Now, let's turn those off. Let's go to our background, and let's pick the paint bucket tool that's near the gradient. It's just G. Turn that on. If you hold Alt, it turns your mouse into a color pick. You click once, then you pick the color. Make sure you have the background selected, and then click once, boom, paint bucket tool, which looks like the Patreon logo a little bit. Nice. And what else do we have? Diagonal lines everywhere. A lot of diagonal lines. Let's create a rectangle. Click on the rectangle tool on the left here. Create one rectangle. Nice. Turn on your color layer, double click on the icon to change the color of the rectangle, and then click, and then your mouse turns to a color picker here. Just click on that color. Now you have the right color. Turn off the colors here, and then you can click on the move tool. Hold Alt, click and drag to duplicate. And we're just gonna duplicate a little bit and duplicate some more, click and drag to duplicate. As you can see, it's creating more layers, right? Now I can select them. I'm holding Shift and click on top one, so it selects everything in between. Control Alt T to transform, hover over a corner to get the rotate tool, click, hold Shift, drag. I'm holding Shift just so it drags per increment and not just like that. So one, two, that is 30 degrees, release, press enter, and then you can move if you have the move tool selected, top here, of course. That's not bad. I'm gonna hold Alt, click and drag to duplicate. Control Alt T to transform. hover over a corner, rotate, holding shift, and then basically get it the same type of rotation. Nice. Okay, now up top here, you're gonna see I have a ruler. You can activate this by pressing Control R. You can right click to put it to percentage to make sure that you have the 50%. That's basically a way to allow me to see where the middle actually is. And you can just click and drag from the sides or from the top to create some lines. You can also get rid of them by clicking and dragging them away. Really trying to give you all the information at once here. I still have my left side selected. So let's basically pick exactly where we want it to be. I kind of want it pretty close like that. And let's hold shift, select all those and try to intersect them in a way. That looks good to me. And now let's turn on our poster here. What do we have? We have a bunch of lines that are straight and then diagonal, straight, diagonal. All right, let's do this. There's multiple ways of doing this, but we can click and hold on the shape tool, basically click on line. Up top here, you can see what the width is. I'm gonna lower this to like 2 because it needs to be very thin. Click on the, click back to the line, sorry. And here I'm going to preemptively select the color white because we saw that was white on the poster, right? Take a quick look again. So I'm gonna click and drag while holding shift so it keeps it, you know, stable. And I'm gonna keep my mouse at the end here. I'm gonna release, I'm gonna click once again, drag. I'm gonna kind of like eyeball basically the angle here. It's supposed to be 30 degrees, but ain't nobody got time for that. Release, keep your mouse there, click, drag. That's not bad. Click, then drag down. This is a mess, so hopefully you want to rearrange this and actually name your layers, but let me pick all those. Let me click on them to make sure I know what is what. All right, so up to shape 5, I'm gonna bring that up. You can even group them if you want. But while I have the shape tool selected, I can change the color here on the fill part and I can click on white and that changes it to white. Click away, boom, this is what we have. It's not looking too good. Let me group them, selecting them and pressing Control G. And I can duplicate them, clicked on the move tool. I can duplicate them on the layers list by holding Alt, dragging up. Control Alt T to transform. Right click, hopefully that works. Flip horizontally, nice. And now you can just drag until that fits. All right, it's a little low. Let's press down on the keyboard to adjust it and boom, there we are. And we can click on that first folder again and we're gonna use the other technique to duplicate stuff. We're gonna hold Alt, click, drag. We're gonna do the same thing with the other one. Hold Alt, click, drag. There you go. Now, what's missing is the glow. I know there's like some dragon details, whatever is that. We're not gonna put that. We need the glow and we need some little, some form of little details. We'll get to that, all right? So for the glow, to make it easy, I'm going to group up all those shapes, all the diagonal rectangles, Control G. And I'm gonna go to the effects option here or layer style. Click once and then find outer glow. Glow that's on the outside. Put it here so you can see what you're doing. Click on the color. Click the red, click OK, and now you can play around with the size, for example. Now that's not bad. I'm just gonna lower the opacity because I don't want it to be that visible. Okay, now for the details, I'm gonna create a new layer by clicking on new layer at the bottom here. I'm gonna pick my brush tool. I'm gonna right click and see what kind of shapes they have. There is a square here, like that. I'm gonna hold Alt on my keyboard and then click on the red to pick it, to color pick it. Now if I click here, for example, boom, I have a red square. Can make that smaller and add more little details. You can also click once somewhere, place your mouse somewhere else, hold shift, and it will create a straight line. And this is just random stuff, right? This is just random details that you're putting a little everywhere. And people are gonna be like, wow, this graphic design is so complex. No, it's not. And the extra detail is like a little bit of shading. And in that case, we're gonna create a new layer. Again, we're gonna press B to, well, we're already on the brush tool actually. We're gonna go back to our feathered brush here. Make sure hardness is 0 and we're gonna go big this time. We're gonna hold Alt to color pick. We're gonna pick that background blue. We're gonna click on colors here. Make sure you can see that, okay. We're gonna go slightly darker and we're basically gonna dap it somewhere, either at the bottom or the top. I think bottom might be better. Click once, click twice, nice. I'm gonna press V to pull up the move tool. Drag this away, we don't need it anymore. And this is the part where we crop our panel to look like a panel. I'm gonna press C for the crop tool, gonna drag this up, because I want it to be a rectangular panel after all. Boom, there you go. Press OK. On that gradient that we just put, it doesn't have to be like that. We can play around with the blending mode, see what sticks, what looks better. Linear burn, maybe a little too dark. What if I lower the fill? Just like that. I think that's pretty cool. I can control Alt T to transform. I can hold Alt to drag the sides if I want to make it bigger, or if I can hold Shift also to stretch it like that, which is what I want. I want the bottom part to be a little darker. That's not bad. Okay, you can adjust some stuff. Like, I don't like how visible those white lines are, so we can go ahead and select those and then lower their opacity. 46%, click away. Okay, now that's looking good. And all we have to do now is add some text that is, you know, vaguely reminiscent of Valorant. But remember, we're taking inspiration. We're not necessarily recreating the Valorant thing, although this is very, very close. Click on the text tool or type tool, if you will, and then type. What I usually do for panels, I type the longest word that I can find that's gonna be in my design, basically. Usually that's Instagram or subscriber or subscribe, just so I can know the width and the size of my text, right? You don't want to change the size of the text. It looks messy. So the text tool is struggling a lot right now. Going on. Come on, Photopea. This is very bad timing. Oh no. Okay, looks like the text tool completely froze on me. I was gonna scrap the video, restart over again, but this is a great occasion to show you, you know, how you can get out of a pickle, right? How to think creatively in order to just keep moving and do your stuff. This still works, right? I can still zoom in. I just want to have this as big as possible. I'm gonna drag the layer handle to the side until I have like a big view of this. And I'm gonna basically use my snipping tool, or just take a screenshot, basically. Nice, now I have a screenshot. We're just gonna open up another instance of Photopea. I'm gonna click new project, and it automatically will take, it should automatically take whatever I have as my width and height, but I'm gonna put 640 again, 300 DPI, click create, and then Control V. All right, Control Alt T to transform, of course, and drag the sides until it fits, and then don't worry, we're gonna crop it again. Press enter, press C to crop. Press enter. It feels like we lost a little bit of resolution. That's not a huge issue if you're doing like panels because they're very small. But if you're doing something like a YouTube banner that's gonna be pretty big on someone's screen, you might want to consider sharpening it or something like that. And now let's press the type tool and click once. Ah, it seems like it's working now. Okay, and type, remember when I said you type the biggest thing, usually Instagram or subscribe, but we're just gonna make an about me section here. I'm gonna type about, I'm gonna select it. Up here near the size, you can click on the word size and then drag up, make it big. Click anywhere away from the text to move it. Nice, click on the color up here and then change it to white because we want it to be very visible. And then from here, you can add a bunch of effects to it, right? To make sure that is centered though, you want to press Control A, that selects everything. Click on the move tool and then up top, you will see center horizontally and center vertically, based on basically the selection. Control D to deselect. And now just to make it stand out so it doesn't blend in with the background at all, we can add like a drop shadow. Click on effects, click drop shadow. Nice, play around with it until you actually like it. You can play with the angle, so where the light would be coming from to create this shadow. Lower the opacity, you don't want the effect to be too pronounced, or maybe you do, I don't know you. Linear burn, you can change the blending mode. I like linear burn because it's so intense, but also it affects the color. We have a brighter red here, for example. I don't know, it looks more realistic to me. Nice, you can also add a stroke, which is the outer layer, put like a gray, also lower the opacity if you want to, and all of that good stuff. But basically this is it. Once you're done, you click file, export as PNG, you click save, and boom, you can see the other one that I made. Now, I know I said, okay, you have to get inspired. It doesn't have to be. For example, one thing that you can change is the colors, because we were inspired by the style and not necessarily the colors. In this example, since we have like a flat image, I can go ahead and add an adjustment layer, hue saturation, and then switch the hue, right? And this is how I came about the other one. Right? Because it's two colors, right? It was red and blue, and they're not necessarily like the best color combination. If you want to colorize everything to have one single color, you can do that. Just click colorize. Make sure you bump up your saturation a little bit so it's very visible. And now, look at that. Whatever color you want, you got it. And the funny thing is that this doesn't necessarily scream Valorant. This could be your branding, and you essentially kind of, you know, usually don't want to copy that much, but kind of made something original out of it. But anyways, since this one bugged out on me, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make the other one available to you for free. Check out the link in the description. I'm going to drop it. And if you open it, this is what it's going to look like. It's not going to be there for forever though, but I just taught you how to make it from scratch. So don't come at me. Here you're going to see up top, there's a hue saturation thing. You can just turn that off if you want the original colors. And if you want to change the text right there about, just double click on the T and then type whatever you want to type. Of course, it has like more effects, and maybe this looks a little bit better. Doesn't matter. But anyways, I will put this link in the description so that you can use it. Now, this is just the Valorant style that we were able to replicate in this video. Initially, I wanted to make four different styles. So if you have any games that you actually love the UI and the design, you would like for me to make more videos about it, maybe we can make a banner next time. Maybe we can make a YouTube banner. Maybe we can make thumbnails. Maybe we can make a camera overlay. Just let me know which games. Just let me know which games in the comment section below. Share this with your streamer friends. They might need it to make better looking panels. And also follow me on Twitch, because I stream there. That being said, thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys next time. Don't forget to check out the links in the description. Go out there, make me proud, get a level, out.